Okay, we have processed all the data in ArcGIS and exported it. Now we have to import it in HEC-RAS and process it in HEC-RAS, and you see, just because I have a new project, there's a new project here is HEC-RAS project, HEC-RAS, you see. Yes, this is a new project. So now we have to import the file, import ArcGIS data from the desktop here. So this is the data which we okay, this is the the river, the cross section, everything with data we created in ArcGIS, and it needs some processing here. For example, there are bridges here, and the bridge must be designed. You see, three bridges, you can see three bridges. So this needs to be designed, and also the cross sections need to be filtered. You see, sometimes there is redundancy. These points might be redundant, unnecessary, lots of points. So in one section, if there are more than 500 stations points, then the HEC-RAS will, you see, will remove for us. You see, here is a filter. You can see we can edit here some moves like this, but this is a filter point. I mean, it will filter for us. You see, here are lots of points here, 152. If it thinks that it is redundant, it will. Oh, sorry, I made a mistake. See, we need to filter. You see, now it filtered out for us 140 pointers, new pointers. The other 12 removed. So that's how HEC-RAS filter out some of the pointers, redundant pointers. That's all. The bridges, we have to design them. So need some. You see, for example, now cancel. Here, the bridges are here. Let us start from the upper side bridge. You see, it's the highest elevation is 83 something point 4. So we need to design like a bridge like this. It comes up, and also we need to put some piers. P points, 1, 2, 3, something like that. So to do that, first let us put this, for example, here the distance at the upstream side. You see, we can see it here in how much we did. You see, 47.9. From the, I think if we are not, is 47.9. That's the, we designed it as 10 before. The next is 29, I think. This is 29.7 or something like that. You can check it here. Yes, and also the width is 15. Yes. So we can say okay, and the third might be like this, 25 and it is 16.6. That's how it is designed before we processed the data in ArcGIS. So yeah, bridge design, yeah. So let us, number of fields might be here 3. Spacing between might be, let us assume how much, 200 in between. No, this one is starting station. 200 is this point is a starting point where the pier starts, and pier spacing maybe this is given 300, and the width of the pier is, it's in US customer unit here. According to this, the app make a pier, we can make this as it is. For example, this is we can see this is 83.84. We can do this manually like this. Maybe if there is another way to do it, I will find out. But I can do it like this for now. So that is it. It's 3.4, and assume that it has a 2 meter or 1 meter lower lower chord. Maybe it is a bridge with a thickness of 2 meter. Maybe let us assume 82, 1.4 meter. Is that thick enough for very long? River, so let us make it 3 meters up. 80.4 is a lower cut, let it be 3 meter thickness. Bridge designers will decide which one, which will be the best, you see. But let us, for hydrology, let us do it like this. Okay, Sebo, copy to the downstream side also. That is it. Our bridge is wonderfully made, you see. So we have a beautiful looking bridge. So similarly for other bridges as well, similarly we can process it. This is a bridge, so file, now exit, save geometrical data, geo, HEC-RAS, just the name simply, say long, geo1, geometry1, and the place where I'm going to put it here. Backstar. So that's wonderful. So the geometrical file is saved. Now we need some hydrological data. So steady flow analysis. Here we need three profiles. Three profiles means three recurrence interval data, maybe at each point, at each for example 100 years, 200 years, 300 years, something like that, discharge data. That's just given here simply as a just to try the process mapping. Simply it's given here. I don't know whether it is the true discharge value of Baxter or something like that, but it is given here 2500 and 50,000. It's in feet cube, in cubic feet per second, I think. 10,000, 100,000, yeah, 1,000, it's 2,000, it's given 4,000. 100,000, 96,000. This is the applied data. This is the upstream information. I think this is upstream, yeah. Upstream information. So the raw stream information is normal depths 0.001. It's given. Yes, so we save flow data like HEC-RAS flow data 1, maybe we can say HEC-RAS flow data 1. This is here desktop. We save it here. Saved it. Okay, it's good, I think. So now we can run the steady flow. Running good without any problem. Fantastic. Now we have got the result, so we need to export this to GIS, export to GIS, especially the higher value, the one which has a higher value is P3, profile 3. So we don't do it here. Let us put it at here. Here. No. GO1. So export the data created. Thank you very much. Now everything is created. Now we have to go to the GIS and import it into GIS. Yes, to draw the inundation funnel. So import here, Open it up. GO1 we said, I think. GO1, okay. Format converted. Now the next step is making a multiplier. Here, flow, steady state flow. Flow 1. Let us say steady state. Why do you steady state? Okay, export file. Is XML. This one is the one which exported. So now we can create. So here the file must be steady state a folder. That is the folder. Okay. Okay, we have imported the we have to import it into RAS. Yes, GORAS, we have to import it here like this. Wonderful. Okay, successfully it's imported. This is it. See, this is the file. But we can see the it's in the river. You see what it is. My God, it's wonderful. So now the inundation map, we go here, inundation mapping, water surface generation from this. You ask, you see, this is the water surface generation. And the next will be, you see, we can see, okay, just simply to see it. This is the one which generated now. Okay, we'll see it later. Generating now the final flood. My God, this is complete. You see our calculation? This is the result we got, you see. I think similar with the tutorial, exactly similar. The floods, both floods, this is, there are a lot of inundation areas here. This is a flood map, you see. This one is also very, very vulnerable area. You see, let us see. Thank you. Okay, this has to be like this. Maybe like this. So that we can see. Exactly. This is a flat. And we can see, we can change the property of the this one symbol. Something like that. So this is the flood map of the area. It's very wonderful. It's very wonderful to see this. You can see the aerial photograph as well. I think this has to come here. You see? So maybe let us make it here. Yes. This one is that's TAPF3, yes, yes. Now, this is clearly visible, you see, the area, even we can remove this one and see how much the area is affected by the flooding, you see. These are the areas where flooding might occur, you see, susceptible areas. This part of the river is very narrow, the water may accumulate back or something like that. It's a lot of water around this area. It's possible to see in the, let us see, it's already in the ground. See, this is a very, it's clearly visible from here that the area needs to be, you see, it's just simply like a dam area or something like that. This is a reservoir. So our calculation is very, very almost perfect calculation. I can see maybe a little bit here. Need some investigation. See, rerun the program to find out if we are correct or not. And it needs also experience with the software and with the ground as well. So a person has to go there and visit the area, or the designer, or he has to know the place very well so that he can analyze his result, verify his result with the ground situation. So it's very wonderful to have this. This is called flood mapping in HEC-RAS. Thank you very much for listening. It was wonderful, wonderful. Thank you very much. Okay. GG. Thank you. This seems correct, I think. After correcting the data, the result I found is this one. So it seems right, I think. Okay, I think this is okay.